Let us analyze the horizontal circular motion of a pendulum box. I think all of you are aware about a simple pendulum in which there is a bob of mass m connected to a string of length l. Say the simple pendulum is hanging in the state of equilibrium at rest. If we tilt the simple pendulum to a particular position, say we tilt it by an angle theta, and we throw the bob in a direction perpendicular to the plane of this paper. So if I throw it in this direction, inward or outward, we can imagine that as soon as I throw it inward, it may be possible that it starts revolving in a horizontal circular path. And in this situation, when the bob will be revolving in the horizontal circle, you can see the string of this pendulum will circulate in the fashion of a cone. And this type of pendulum or this type of motion of pendulum we term as conical pendulum. This termed as conical pendulum because the string is circulating in such a manner it is describing a cone. In this situation, if it is revolving in a stable conical fashion, we can simply state the bob will be in the state of horizontal circular motion with uniform speed. Say, if it is revolving with a speed v, we can simply state at a position it will be experiencing mg in downward direction. It will be experiencing the tension T along the length of the string. These are the only forces acting on the bob. In this situation, if we just talk about the components of this string tension, in this situation this will be T cos theta, and along the radial direction inward toward the center it will be T sin theta. Now in this situation T sin theta is the force which is acting toward the center of circle, and this T sin theta is providing the necessary centripetal force for this bob to remain in uniform circular motion. So we can say for uniform and stable horizontal circular motion, we can directly use in this situation T sin theta is the centripetal force, which should be mv square by r if r is the radius of the circle, and T cos theta in this situation is balancing the weight of bob, that is mg. From these equations 1 and 2, we can relate several parameters of this conical pendulum. Like if we divide these equations 1 by 2, you can see tensions gets cancelled out, and it will be 10 theta is equals to v square upon rg, or it gives the speed with which it should be thrown so as to revolve in a stable circular path as root of rg 10 theta. These are the relations you should keep in mind. Direct problems can be asked based on this. If we are required to find the value of tension, you can square and add these equations and take the root of that. Like if we take 1 square plus 2 square root, on left hand side you can see we are getting only tension. On right hand side it will be m into root of V 4 by R square plus G square. This is the relation which is giving us the tension in a string of this conical pendulum. So be careful about these relations by which we can analyze various parameters of this conical pendulum.